Welcome to this year's Alamance County Law Enforcement Memorial Service. I'm Chief David Prevent with Alamance Community College Police, and on behalf of the Law Enforcement Executive Group, it is my honor to have each and every one of you with us today as we pay honor and respect to the 12 fallen heroes within our county and all of our fallen brothers and sisters in the law enforcement profession. So please rise for the presentation of colors by the Alamance County Unified Honor Guard and remain standing for the singing of the national anthem by Officer Eric Franklin, Nevin Police Department, and the placement of the memorial wreath by the Alamance County Unified Honor Guard.
Dawn's early light, what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watch, were so gallantly streaming. And the rockets' red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave? Oh, the land of the free and the
let us pray. Eternal God, we thank you for the gift of life. We thank you for those who dedicate their lives to the service and the protection of others. We thank you, and we thank them for the sacrifices that they and their families make daily as they work to make the lives of others better and safer. We're thankful for their commitment to society, to the rule of law, and to justice. We honor today these public servants who have made the ultimate sacrifice. May this ceremony honor them and their legacy. May it serve as a sense of comfort to their families and to their colleagues. And may it be a statement that their sacrifice was not in vain, that they are remembered for the exceptional human beings they were. Amen. You may be seated, gentlemen.
As you entered the room this morning, you may have noticed a small table in a place of honor. It is set for one. This table is our way of symbolizing the fact that members of our profession of arms are missing from our midst. Law enforcement in Alamance County is steeped with symbolism and tradition. On display, left, center of the stage today, is a small table symbolizing the fact that our fellow officers have been taken from us. The table is set for one. It is small, symbolizing the frailty of one against the lawless. The tablecloth is white, symbolizing the purity of their intentions to respond to the community's needs. The single rose in a vase reminds us of the life of our fallen officers, the families, the loved ones. The black ribbon, tied so prominently around the vase, is reminiscent of the mourning bands worn upon our badges of the law enforcement brothers and sisters who bear witness to their unyielding determination to protect and serve our communities. A slice of lemon sits on the plate to remind us of their bitter fate. The salt sprinkled on the plate symbolizes the tears shed by loved ones and friends. The glass inverted symbolizes their inability to share a toast with us. The chair is empty. They are not here. The candle is lit, symbolizing the upward reach of their unconquerable spirit. Our 12 fallen officers, our heroes, gone but never forgotten.
Honor the more than 900,000 law enforcement officers in our nation's profession today who go to work each and every day to protect and serve our communities and remember their families and their personal sacrifice. There was 146 officers that died in the line of duty in 2019. It is up to all of us to bear true witness to the bravery and sacrifice made by the heroes we honor today by remembering that we all have a personal role to play in keeping our neighborhoods safe. We must take responsibility for the problems we face in our communities and take a stand against crime, both large and small. We must help each other in the time of need, and we must teach our children the difference between right and wrong. The candle that was lit today will not burn for long, but it reminds us that we must all be the keepers of the flame once burned by our fallen heroes. Today, we had a vigil, and every day we must be vigilant. So let us bind ourselves together with a new bond of service to make our community brighter, safer, and more hopeful. And in doing so, let us honor the memory of our fallen heroes each day. It is my honor to introduce today's speaker, Mr. Robert Lane, Assistant U.S. Attorney for the Middle District of North Carolina. Mr. Lane has served as a dedicated prosecutor in North Carolina since 1990, both on the state and federal level. He serves in the Middle District, focused on Project Safe Neighborhood Coordinator, which focuses on violent crimes in our community. He feels that the model that brings the non-traditional partnerships together to solve real problems through better use of data, consistent building, and improving relationships. So please help me welcome Mr. Robert Lane, Assistant U.S. Attorney.
Thank you, Chief Trevett. President Teddy Roosevelt, who was the 26th President of the United States, was also the former police commissioner of the city of New York. He said, "No man is worth his salt who is not ready to risk his body, to risk his well-being, to risk his life in a great cause." Policing with honor in the United States is a great cause. It's an incredible privilege to be here in Alamance County, to stand here on this solemn occasion, to remember those who have given all they have in service of this county, this state, and our great country. 13 officers of the law from 7 law enforcement agencies over the past 150 years have given all they have to protect and serve the citizens of this county. You know their heroic stories, responding to assist others, thwarting burglaries and vehicle thefts, apprehending the dangerous, lost forever, protecting the helpless, serving the people, and maintaining order, protecting the lawful from the lawless. As I drove into this great county this morning, I passed exit 132 that honors Trooper W.T. Davis. I learned this reading the stories about your great fallen officers. I will never drive down I-40 again without thinking of this solemn day and the 13 people who gave their lives for the citizens of this county. There have been too many that did not get to finish their tour of duty. From the New King James Version, greater love has no one than this, than to lay down one's life for his friends. This memorial service, this vigil, with all its ceremonial splendor, the moving invocation, the national anthem, the honor guard, the table ceremony, the laying of the wreaths, the reciting of the honor roll, the recognition of the families and colleagues of the fallen who still can remember, the comments and presence of our leaders, and the playing of taps. The silence is to make us reflect. It is to give us time to think, to remember those who gave the ultimate, and also to contemplate the future. This memorial service is to honor the legacies of the past, but to look to the future. If we do not look to the future, we fail to live up to the sacrifices that have been made by those who came before us. We must live up to their ideals and their aspirations. We must live up to their commitment, the commitment that our fallen brethren died for. They died for the rule of law, for the triumph of order over chaos, protecting at all costs the thin blue line. As I got dressed this morning, I had to make sure that my shirt and tie went with my pants. So many of the meetings and Zooms and conference calls only required me to look professional from the waist up. For weeks, I didn't shave because before we were able to get the technology right, everything was done on the phone or through text or email. It was amazing how much business we can get done despite this COVID pandemic. But the law officer doesn't get to do it halfway. The law officer doesn't get a benefit from COVID-19. The law officer doesn't get extra time to spend with family at home. The law officer still has to commute to work. The law officer still has to wear their full uniform, still has to deal with people face to face. The law officer is out there in the world, in full view at all times, enforcing, keeping order over chaos. The law officer cannot do his work on the phone or a laptop or from the comfort of his living room or her dining room table. He or she is out there in the community where there is commotion and unrest and anger and substance abuse, and yes, unfortunately, evil. When there is danger lurking, they drive in while we drive out. The thin blue line. An anonymous law officer once wrote, "I don't have to draw a line in the sand. I already have one. It's thin. It's blue. It's mine. And if you cross it, I will protect it." You are blessed here in Alamance County with strong and experienced leaders in law enforcement, prosecution, and probation. You are blessed to have leaders who have integrity and character, even when no one is looking. You are blessed that they work together for the good of all to keep the peace. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall become the children of God. From Matthew chapter 5, verse 9. And to close, the true measure of a person is not found in the might of their arm, their wealth, or their power. It is found in the strength of their character. There is no greater testimony to one's character than one's willingness to sacrifice all in the noble quest of providing protection to all. Protection to all whom they serve. On this solemn day, we thank those fallen officers and their families. We thank the current officers who go out into harm's way to protect us and to serve us. We thank the citizens of this great county who support law enforcement who stand behind law enforcement and stand behind the rule of law. All those things honor those 13 individuals that made the ultimate sacrifice, some as long as 150 years ago. May God bless you, the men and women of law enforcement in this county and across this great nation. But especially may God bless the families and those who have given their lives in service of others.
Wyatt Outlaw, Graham Police Department, February 26, 1870. George J. Massey, Alamance County Sheriff's Office, March 3, 1934. Lawrence George Gowans, Alamance County Sheriff's Office, July 31st, 1936. Marcellus P. Robertson, Alamance County Sheriff's Office, December 7th, 1938. Sonny W. Vaughn, Burlington Police Department, December 7, 1938. Adelbert S. Williams, Gibsonville Police Department, May 2, 1940. Jerry Gideon Davis, Alamance County Sheriff's Office, September 1, 1970. George Lee Lashley, Gibsonville Police Department, June 30th, 1973. William Alton Robertson, Jr., Graham Police Department, July 12th, 1978. William Bryant Davis, North Carolina Highway Patrol, October 21st, 1999. Robert J. Bowling, North Carolina Division of Motor Vehicles, License and Theft Bureau, May 21st, 2015. Jared Franks, Greensboro Police Department, November 10th, 2018.
A folded flag stained with tears. They remove the match from your chest. God, this can't be real. Now you walk a beat in heaven on God's streets of gold. When I take my last breath, you'll be waiting at heaven's door. Hollow ground stands a stone, a solemn lion who stands alone. A tribute to your honor and fallen brothers too. Lives taken out of anger for hatred of the blue. If it wasn't for the band, the bagpipes would not play. Beautiful, amazing grace, as they fold the flag and pray. The bugle would be silent, rifles would not draw. If it wasn't for the badge, there would be no final call. Carved on these walls, the sacrifice one gives. It's not how they died, it's how they lived. If it wasn't for the badge, the bagpipes would not play. Beautiful, amazing grace, as they fold the flag and pray. You would be silent, the rifles would not draw. If it wasn't for the badge, there would be no final call. I know God called you home, and I miss you so bad. But I never would have met you if it wasn't for the band.
behalf of the law enforcement that are represented here, the departments, we want to honor the families of the fallen officers today in Alamance County. Thank you for your attendance. Precious Lord, may those who mourn those we honor today be granted your comfort. May the families of those who continue to serve be granted peace of heart and mind. May those who serve be granted wisdom and strength. May those who serve be granted your protection. May the example of these we remember today create in us a renewed commitment to serve each other, even as they served. May their sacrifice teach us the value and worth of helping and protecting each other. And in that way, may we honor them and their sacrifice daily as we live out their example. Amen. This will conclude our service today. Thank you.